John Bollinger 是美国最著名的证券分析师之一，他发明的布林线至今仍在各大分析软件当中使用。他今天为我们带来什么样的投资理念呢？我们一起来听一下吧。
Thank you so much for joining us, Mr. Bollinger. So based on your strategy, the Bollinger Band in China A shares will be around its 5 years high. Do you think it will outbreak the upper range or it will fail?
So we've come an awful long way in a relatively short period of time. In technical analysis, we refer this as an overbought condition. Mm-hmm. So I think that in the short to intermediate term, we could see a consolidation or even a pullback. But longer term, I think prices will probably work their way higher, which is to say I'm quite bullish on the Chinese shares.
Thank you. And it's the same scenario with NASDAQ and S&P 500. What do you think about those? Will they rise or?
I think for the next 6 to 9 months or so, U.S. stock prices will continue higher. We may see some volatility, some pullbacks against the trend, but I would be very surprised if July, August, September, if U.S. equity prices weren't much higher than they are now.
Thank you. And the next question I want to ask you about the Apple stock price. So Apple has hit its all-time record high. Do you think it will, and the Bollinger band, Apple stock price hit the Bollinger band, then it went down. Do you think it will come back again, or is it the perfect setup to sell Apple?
I don't think Apple's done yet. So I think we could have a short-term top here and a pullback. But Apple is what we call a fad stock. It's a stock in which many, many people are interested in. I think there's a tremendous amount of demand for it. And we don't see the classic signs that we would see of a long-term top for a stock in Apple yet.
And then what about Alibaba? Alibaba stock price has hit a bottom low since its IPO. So based on your strategy, do you think it will come back again?
The problem with stocks that have just come out of an IPO is two things. First of all, investors don't know the stocks very well. They don't have a long history, so they're unsure in their operations. Mm-hmm. And second of all, IPOs tend to be priced relatively high compared to the value of the stock, so it's very typical for stocks to pull back after an IPO, which is, I think, what's happened with Alibaba. And what we want to see now is some price development, get investors more comfortable with the stock, and then see if we can move prices higher.
Okay. Do you think there will be more selling after Alibaba's lockup period ends, I think, March 18th?
The problem with that sort of view is that so many people know about this. Everybody's looking for it to happen. For example, Google, which went through a similar IPO cycle, everybody thought that when Google's lockout period ended, there would be a tremendous amount of selling. It just didn't happen. I don't think it will happen in Alibaba either.
Okay. Well, thank you. Thank you so much for being with us.
Oh, my pleasure entirely.